time AWA World Heavyweight Champion, WCW Superstar and Broadcaster on the Superstation, TBS, a WWE Hall of Famer, professional golfer, and the master of the art of human chess, the legend, Larry Zbysko. Welcome everybody to Larry Land. How are you, Larry?
Well, thank you. Good introduction there, Matt. I'm doing great. Looking forward to this.
Awesome. Well, a man that is truly one of my heroes in wrestling and broadcasting is Mr. Zbysko, the legend. Incredibly smooth, both in the ring and on the mic. And we have to start with something related to your epic feud with Bruno Sammartino. I grew up on Long Island Sound. Bruno was such a hero to everybody. My Italian grandmother even knew who Bruno Sammartino was. But we heard everybody ask you a lot of questions, the typical interview, but we don't do that here on the King's Court. We want to ask you about the story that involved Bruno and a notorious character in American history. This story involves a Polish flashlight.
Are you ready for it?
Let's have it.
Okay. Well, you know, it was one of the many adventures I had with Bruno, which was, you know, not the normal kind of adventure. He knew so many people. And Bruno knew Frank Sinatra. Frank or Bruno, they were good friends. And Frank Sinatra had a right-hand man where Frank really wouldn't go anywhere without Jimmy Rizzo. Jimmy was Frank's, you know, best friend and right-hand man. And in New York City, I think it was on 52nd Street, there was a club called Jilly's. Jilly's had a little nightclub. Not a big place, but a nice little, you know, nightclub called Jilly's. So I think this was in 1977. Sinatra was doing a live show at the Garden. And I think I got the CD of that. And after the Garden, he was going to go to Jilly. So Jilly called Bruno and invited Bruno to come. Frank wanted to say hi, and Jilly wanted to see Bruno and all that. So we were in town that day for doing, I think, the Garden the next day or something. So we go off to Jilly's place. Me, Bruno, Dominic DiNucci, and Tony Parisi. And I'm the young kid, you know, I'm the Polish guy. So we're in this little place, and it's crowded. It's like shoulder to shoulder. And they bumped into stars. I bumped into Henny Youngman, Shelly Winters, Jill St. John, and a couple other ones. You know, all in to say hi to Frank. And Frank was kind of in the back room. And he went back to Bruno, and I met Frank. He was a lot shorter and smaller than I thought he'd be. So we met Frank, and he's surrounded by these big bugs. And we go back out, and Bruno's kind of sitting there by the bar, and I'm kind of standing there, not far from him, and there's a crowd of people, and through this crowd coming at me is a little old man that looks like a skeleton. He's so old and feeble looking. And he's got a couple of big thugs on each side of him, but there's people all over, and I know nothing. And he comes up to me, and he's got in his hand an empty roll of toilet paper. A brown plastic, you know, brown cardboard toilet paper roll. And at the end, one end, there's matchsticks taped to the end of it. And he comes up to me with this thing, and he says, "Do you know what this is?" And I said, "No." And he says, "This is the Polish flashlight." And everybody in the room laughed their ass off. Okay. So me, in my Polishness, I say, "Well, you know why Italians don't have freckles? They slide off their face." Nobody laughs. And Bruno is sitting by the bar, he hears this, and he's running his thumb across his throat like, "Will you shut up, you idiot?" And then there's this whole guy, and he just starts walking away. And then I find out this little old guy was Carlo Gambino, the godfather, the that was him.
Oh, boy.
Oh, my God.
Anyway, they go on and on.